Greetings, Mavuno. This is your senior pastor, Pastor M, just coming to you at a very important Sunday. This is a Sunday that in just a few days, we're going to be going into our national elections. And I don't know what that evokes in you. For some of you, this is an exciting time when you think about the opportunity to involve yourself democratically in selecting a new leader. For some of you, it may be a time that is fraught with anxiety and the unknown and what's coming ahead. And I just wanted to say, as we are preparing for this time, that God is calling us, and I really do believe in this season, God is calling us to, first of all, not to fear, because He is in control. So that's the first thing I want to say today. Do not fear, because God is in control. But then I also wanted to say that as we're preparing for elections, there's several ways that I believe that God would want us to be a light. He's called us to be a light on a hill. And we, as this family, this community called Mavuno Church, I believe that we have a role to play in the next few days. And so how can you play a part? How can you become the light that God wants you to be? Number one, I want to encourage us as much as possible to go out and vote. If you have a voter's card, if you're one of those people who's registered to vote, and I hope many, many of you are, I want to encourage you to go out and vote. We actually are going to have a polling station at our Hill City headquarters. I'm so excited about that for the first time ever. And I just want to encourage as many of you, exercise your democratic right. I always say that when you are not involved in choosing your leaders, then you really don't have a voice. You cannot criticize what you had no choice, what you had no part in selecting. And so let's all get involved as much as we can and go out and choose. And let me encourage us not to choose based on ethnicity, on fear-mongering, on wasting, people telling you don't waste your vote. Vote for the person that God puts in your heart as the best leader. And let's trust the Lord that He has the leader to select for our nation. But number two, apart from voting, I want to encourage you that you will pray for our nation. This last week and this coming week, we're going to spend time in prayer. I want to invite you to our 4:30 prayers every morning. Even if you've never joined the 4:30 prayers, this will be a fantastic week for you to just join us as we uplift our prayer, our nation in prayer. And I know that in your campus, you're going to be given the link that you can actually join us in that 4:30 prayer. We want to see you praying. And let's just spend time praying that God will select the right leaders, that the Lord would allow this to be a peaceful election, and that there will be no mishaps. We're trusting God for miracles. Many doomsayers will say otherwise, but we will believe in God's report. So let's pray. And then the third thing I want to encourage you to do, if you join me in doing, is being a man or a woman of peace. You know what? This is going to be an emotional time. I believe that there are many who are very invested in this emotion, in this election, very emotionally and sometimes unreasonably. I think one of the things I was saying in one of the churches I preached recently is it's amazing how the principals who we are electing, especially when you think about our president and when you think about our deputy president, when you think about the former prime minister, and that all of them have been in coalition together against one of the others. And so it's been very interesting for me as I look at the last few years in Kenyan politics, to ask, why would we get emotional about these people who have all worked together at different times against each other? And you know what? For them, it really is about getting into power. And you know what? They all have their merits. They all have their demerits. What I want to encourage us is, hey, support your candidate, but don't allow your emotions to get in the way. And also, if you can be an agent of peace in those WhatsApp groups, in social media, this is not a time for us to be silent. It's a time for us to be active in our peace building. And my prayer is that the church will not be silent. The church will be salt and light and will be seen and heard in this time. And so, hey, we are praying together. And I know that we're going to be praying in this service and praying in throughout the rest of this week. But I just want to speak a blessing over every one of us as we go out into this time. I look forward to rejoice in thanksgiving over the Lord's protection over every one of you in this week, over your families and over our nation. God bless you.